Hello everybody and welcome to our virtual open event for Independent Living Skills. My name is Emma Parsons and I'm your presenter this evening, and I'm joined as well by Leanna Smith, who's going to moderate the question and answer. Okay, so you should be able to put any questions that you have during the presentation into the Q&A, and then Leanna will share those with me, or she'll write back to you with her responses. So ILS has lots of different courses, and we have we have courses that you can do for more than 1 year. So we have life skills courses, vocational study courses, and supported internships. And you may do more than 1 year. You may progress from one to the other. So life skills is all about our entry to independent living skills. We are very person-centered, and you can progress onto vocational study after you've done life skills. Vocational study courses have qualifications attached to them, and you also have qualifications in maths and English attached to some of those as well. And then from there, you can also progress to supported internships. This course is offered at Cross Keys, where you would have placements preparing you for the world of work. So what you need to do, if you haven't already, is apply online through the college website. What will happen then is you'll be on our system. If you search for courses and you type in ILS, the main program will come up and you should be able to select the correct campus, the nearest campus for you. Once you have applied, you'll be on our system, and if we need to change the course for you, staff can do that at our end. So where is your nearest campus? We have different campuses. One at Blaenau Gwent Learning Zone in Ebervale, one in Newport, one in Cross Keys, and one in Pontypool, which will soon be moving to the Torvine Learning Zone. And we also have a sister campus at Usk. So if you want to put in the Q&A the campus that you are you're nearest to, we can get staff to contact you with more information at a later date. So what is covered? You'll see that our curriculum in ILS is centred around four pillars. We have independence, health and wellbeing, employability and community. And we also have obviously maths, English and digital literacy embedded and taught in those. You have one session of each pillar every week. And for different pillars, we do obviously different activities. Independence is all about doing things for yourself, so preparing you to live more independently. So that might be doing cooking for yourself, household activities. It may be that you are relying less on other people at home for independence. And there's lots of practice and doing the same task over and over to develop your confidence with independence. We do health and well-being, and that's all about diet, exercise, feeling and being healthy. So we do lots of sport, lots of activities that are healthy mind and healthy body. We also do the employability pillar, which is preparing you for progressing onto another course within the college, or progressing onto work experience or volunteering placements. The community pillar is all about getting out and about and accessing your local community and taking part in activities in the community that benefit other people. So I've got a question for you now. What would you like to learn? If you came to college and you could learn whatever you wanted, what would you like to learn? And if you can put that into our Q&A, that would be great. The reason I ask this is because, as well as the pillared sessions that we have as part of our curriculum, we do electives, so you choose your learning. So in the past we've done lots of different electives, and you can see by the pictures on the screen we do things like hospitality, which is all about serving, making food and drink. We do things like photography and media, so using cameras. We've got courses that work with animals, so that might be small pets and also farm animals. We do arts and crafts. We also do gym and exercise activities, sport and leisure, drama, which is absolutely brilliant, and also Duke of Edinburgh. So electives differ from campus to campus, and they're also put on in response to learner interest. So if lots of people are interested in a certain thing, staff will try, if possible, to put an activity on for those learners. It gives you a chance for you to try perhaps a course that you might like to progress on to after ILS. And it also gives you a chance to try things that you might like to do for a hobby or for an interest when you are at home in your free time or after the ILS course. This slide's all about additional learning support, okay? So it's really important that you let us know if you need any support when you're with us at college. So you need to tell us if you've had any support in the past. So that might be for specialist equipment to help you access facilities or the curriculum. It might be you've had extra time in exams or extra time to complete assignments. It may be that you've had one-to-one support or group support in the past, or it may be that you just need a go-to person that can help you with some parts of college life. So your individual learning journey is going to be different to everybody else's. What will happen once you have applied for a place and you've had a look around the campus and you've been offered a place and you've accepted it, we will start your individual learning journey by inviting you in to complete a personal review. What you do then is you sit with a tutor, and you'll have somebody from home with you as well, and we'll ask questions about each of the four pillars of the curriculum. You'll score yourself at how confident you are, and at the end of each section, we'll identify an individual target that you actually want to work on and that's going to be relevant and meaningful for you. What we'll do then is we'll set that target, and you'll be working on that while you're in college and hopefully while you're at home. We'll formally review these targets around Christmas time, and we'll be able to record any progress that you've made. And then we will also, if need be, set some more targets for you. What we do around Easter time then is have another personal review, and we'll talk about how you've progressed with your targets. And we'll also confirm what direction you're going to move into next year. So we'll confirm the destination. So that might be that you're staying in the ILS department on a similar course. It may be that you're progressing from one course to the other in the department, or it may be that you're going out and out of the ILS department and progressing onto a level one mainstream course, which would be brilliant. Some people might progress onto a volunteering placement or even paid employment as well. Liana, do we have any questions that I can answer now, or that you have you responded to them in the chat?
No, not currently, Emma. We haven't got any questions that you need to answer.
Lovely. That's great. Okay. Thanks very much. I'll keep going. Yeah, that's great. So you choose how to record your journey, and we do this in lots of different ways at the college. So we give everybody a personal journey book. Now, this is like a little diary that goes home with you every day and that we use when we're in college. What you will do in here is you'll put your personal targets in here. It may be that you write in the back of it any sort of communication, any information that we need to share between home and college. We put reminders in there if you need to bring any specific kits or if we're going on a trip. And we also try to put pictures in there that you can share with people at home to evidence the activities that you have done while you're in college or at home as well. We also have an online personal journey collection, and we use that. We use Wakelet for this, which is absolutely brilliant because we can add documents that you've created. We can take videos or pictures and add those on there. We can put your personal targets on there, and different tutors can then comment of how you've achieved or worked towards your target or how you've progressed. What's really amazing about this is that you can take it with you if you're looking to progress onto a different course, and you can show them the skills that you've got. And even further than that, if you're looking for a work experience placement, or if you're looking for paid employment, you can show them all the things that you have done as well. Of course, we're going to give you booklets to complete, and you're going to have hard copy work that you're going to print out as well, and this will be kept in a personal journey work file on site in college. So the best thing about our department is that we get to do loads of amazing events, and obviously we have different events throughout the year celebrating things like Easter or Christmas. We also get involved in lots of charity activities as well. The events are absolutely brilliant because they give us a chance to invite transitioning learners to the college so they can get a feel for activities that they might be involved in. And it also gives us a chance to invite people at home into the college to share all the amazing things that our learners do. What is great as well is sometimes we have events across the different campuses, so we come together and we really develop a sense of community across all our different sites. So if you haven't already, please apply online, and you can do that through the college course. Like I said, you'll be on our system for staff to invite you into our transition events. Is there anything that I can answer, Leanna?
No, Emma, no questions that need answering.
No questions, that's great. Okay, if anybody has any questions, please feel free to put it into the chat and we can contact you, or a tutor from your nearest campus will be able to contact you. So thank you very much for joining. I've been Emma Parsons, and I've been your presenter, and Leanna's been our moderator. So thank you very much, Leanna, as well.
Thanks, Emma.
If anybody has any questions or wants to get in touch with us, there's loads of different ways that you can do that. You can do it really easily through our college website. And as soon as you have applied for a course, staff will contact you. OK, so thank you very much for joining, and goodbye. And hopefully we'll speak to you soon. Thanks very much. Bye bye.